Welcome to WebStylePress. Today we are looking at website assets management. This guide is for static HTML websites. For other front-end back-end frameworks like React.js, AngularJS, WordPress or Laravel, we may follow different approach for assets management. We are not talking about bundlers or Node.js based workflow environments here. Alright? If you get a good idea and general perspective here, you should be able to grasp idea of good assets management for any other web development project in general. Let's study few concepts before that. So we have types of assets. Assets are images, fonts, videos, audio files, CSS files, JavaScript files, or other files such as favicon or PDF that can be used in web page, that can be linked in a web page. So these are our assets. These are the files that will be used in a web page. Understanding these assets are necessary so that you can arrange these in their own groups. This will help you better organize your workflow, and you will be able to easily find files when you will need to work on your project next time. So website project root directory. Folder that contains index file or home page file is the root directory. In a web server's case, or in a cPanel web server case, public underscore HTML or www is usually the root directory of a web server, or it can be your domain name .com, and in case of local host such as VAMP or XAMPP, it can be www project name, this one, and in case of XAMPP, it can be XAMPP stdocs project name. But if you will access these over a web browser, the path will be like this: http://localhost/your project name. And for Nginx and Plesk, there are different paths depending on web host of your choice. But we are developing on local PC, so we will stick to the local host example. So the folder structure. Better folder structure will enable you to find and work with different type of files quickly and easily, and it will help other developers to find the right files easily. You should group same type of files in one folder. For example, keep all images in folder named as images. Preferably use a single folder named as assets and use other folders inside it based on file types such as images, styles, and scripts and fonts, and manage your assets like that. Don't do this. Like, don't use a single folder and just don't throw all the files inside it. Images and web pages and fonts and JavaScript and CSS files. This is the wrong approach. Use a proper project name. Give your project folder a proper name and use assets folder inside it, and use images, styles, and scripts and fonts folders inside the assets, and keep your index.html or other HTML pages at the root directory inside the project. File hierarchy is also important. While linking to files in your HTML document, you should know which file should be on higher order depending on which library has certain dependencies. For example, jQuery is dependency for jQuery plugins, so it is a good idea to keep jQuery on top of all other jQuery plugins to ensure that those plugins can access jQuery before they initialize their functionality. So I usually do this, like I link Bootstrap before all the CSS files, and then all the vendors can go after that, and at the end I use my own custom.css and responsive.css, and these are my files and these override other vendor files, and I keep my CSS files in the head section of web page. And after that, at the end of whole document before closing body tag, I use jQuery first and then Bootstrap, and then all the other vendors or plugins can go after that, and then at the end custom.js. This is my script file. So naming files and folders in a proper way is very important. Like, this is wrong. Don't use my anywhere. And also, instead of img, css, js, it is better to use proper naming like images, styles and scripts and fonts. Use proper names of folders and files. So this is a better approach. This is a better approach than this one. File paths are also important. Use proper paths to link files. These paths are not correct. This is a wrong way. This path is correct. Given that you have got index.html in your root directory, that is project, and inside the project there is a folder called assets, images inside the assets folder, and inside the images there is an image called .jpg. So you will link to that image in the index.html like this. You'll just mention assets slash images slash image name. I have provided the image tag as well to better understand this concept. Linking assets properly is important. You should link CSS files in head section of web page and link scripts near footer after content of web page before closing body tag. In this way, scripts won't block page rendering and your web page will load faster. So I have this project as an example, and this is my root directory. I have got HTML pages at the root directory, and this is my source folder that contains the vendors, and you can keep the vendors in such folder named as source, and you can copy the JavaScript and CSS files according to requirement from here, and you should keep these in the assets and inside scripts and styles. See, fonts folder contains only font files, and I will keep images in the images folder, and I will keep scripts in scripts folder, and similar for styles. Style folder contains CSS files, and you can see this here as well. I have got assets folder, and I have got these subfolder inside asset folder. Those are fonts and images, scripts and styles. And I have linked the CSS files here like this, and in head section. So assets, styles, bootstrap, and similarly bootstrap theme, font awesome, custom and sponsored.css. And for scripts, I have linked the scripts at the end of all the content of web page, and paths for this is also similar: assets, scripts and jQuery, bootstrap and then custom inside assets and scripts. So this is how you manage assets for a web page or website. I hope you liked the video. Give it a like and subscribe if you haven't already. Take care.